Greetings. Thank you, Brother Hussein, for raising a great point that needs to be explained. The Bible is changed and says so in Jeremiah 8:8. Let us both show Almighty God respect and read the verse in context. Jeremiah 8:1, At that time, declares the Lord, they will bring out the bones of the kings of Judah, and the bones of its princes, and the bones of the priests, and the bones of the prophets, and the bones of the inhabitants of Jerusalem from their graves. So, to set the stage, brother, this is Jeremiah delivering a judgment against Israel. This was a thankless job of a prophet, brother, to call the rebellious back to God. Jesus recounts this as a parable in Luke 20. At the harvest time, he sent a slave to the vine growers so that they would give him some of the produce of the vineyard, but the vine growers beat him and sent him away empty-handed. And he proceeded to send another slave, and they beat him also, and treated him shamefully, and sent him away empty-handed. And he proceeded to send a third, and this one also they wounded and cast out. So the history between God and the Jewish people involved lots of corrections over 3,000 years. I hope you realize how long that is. They will spread them out to the sun, the moon, and to all the host of heaven, which they have loved, and which they have served, and which they have gone after, and which they have sought, and which they have worshipped. They will not be gathered and buried. They will be as dung on the face of the ground. That is not a compliment, brother, right? Jeremiah is judging them. The bones of the kings of Judah, the bones of its princes, of its priests, the bones of its prophets, the bones of the inhabitants of Jerusalem. That sounds pretty much like everybody from the top down. And death will be chosen rather than life by all the remnant that remains of this evil family, that remains in all the places to which I have driven them, declares the Lord of hosts. Wow! Does that sound horrible or what? So bad they will choose death over life. You shall say to them, thus says the Lord, do men fall and not get up again? Does one turn away and not repent? Think about what this is saying, brother. Do men fall and not get up? The answer to this rhetorical question is no, they get up. Likewise, when a man sins, what is the logical, expected next move? Repentance. God's expectation is that when or after people turn away, they then repent. Why then? Great question, and obviously related to the logic of the previous verse. Why then has this people, Jerusalem? Brother, when you read the Word of God in context, it is just so clear. It really does not need to tell you over and over. It is a clear sign. It demonstrates it by just being clear. Why then has this people, Jerusalem, turned away in continual apostasy? They hold fast to deceit. They refuse to return. You know what apostasy is, right, brother? I have listened and heard. They have spoken what is not right. No man repented of his wickedness, saying, what have I done? Everyone turned to his course like a horse charging into the battle. Even the stork in the sky knows her seasons, and the turtle dove and the swift and the thrush observe the time of their migration. But my people do not know the ordinance of the Lord. That last phrase is also translated as the requirements of the Lord, the rules of the Lord, or the Lord's laws. So in this context, this is where we find the lamentation of Jeremiah 8:8. How can you say we are wise and the law of the Lord is with us, But behold, the lying pen of the scribes has made it into a lie. And that single verse, Jeremiah 8:8, is the only thing Islam concerns itself with. Their interest is based on the need to rationalize that the Bible has been corrupted. So keep that in mind. They have an ulterior motive. And the very next verse contributes an interesting insight. Jeremiah 8:9. The wise men are put to shame. They are dismayed and caught. Behold, they have rejected the word of the Lord. And what kind of wisdom do they have? Realize what this says, brother. One cannot reject something that is not available. By stating the wise have rejected the word of God, Jeremiah affirms they have the word of God to accept. Prophet Jeremiah did not say the word of God was lost, gone, changed, corrupted. And that creates one of many problems for Islam's assertions. The very next verse, Jeremiah 8:9, implies they had the correct word of God. And this is one of those situations, brother, when Islam demonstrates deception and ignorance. Ignoring the next words in the very same passage. Brother, that is dishonest and a behavior of deception and fraud. It would be the same if a Christian quoted Surah 573 this way. They do blaspheme who say Allah is one. No honest man would ever misrepresent a text that way. So let's get back to your question. The Bible is changed and says so in Jeremiah 8:8. The Islamic claim relies on a very strained reading of this verse and phrase. And I have shown you, brother, the very next verse confirms the word of God remained. But behold, the lying pen of the scribes has made it into a lie. We have already seen the context and that this speaks of judgment. The scribes are being judged and chastised, as are the rest of the nation of Israel. And Jeremiah does not say the word of God has been corrupted. To understand this, you must honestly consider what is actually said. And to assist, let's look at multiple translations of the original Hebrew of the key phrase. The NIV, when actually the lying pen of the scribes has handled it falsely. English Standard, but behold, the lying pen of the scribes has made it into a lie. King James, lo, certainly in vain he made it. The pen of the scribes is in vain. Holman Christian, in fact, the lying pen of scribes has produced falsehood. International Standard, when in fact the deceitful pen of the scribe has made it into something that deceives. The Net Bible, the truth is, those who teach it have used their writings to make it say what it does not really mean. How can one person or group make the words of another, in this case God, into a lie? Well, first, a critic may simply write, the text is false. It does not mean what you think it means. For example, when God gives one rule, and teachers or scribes allow what God forbid, this would insult the command of God, calling it wrong, a lie. It does not mean they rewrote the command of God. They simply rejected it and contradicted it. Which is perhaps why 8:8 is followed by 8:9. Behold, they have rejected the word of the Lord. This seems a more accurate reading to me, given the context. It would be as if Muslims honored the Hadiths over the Quran, making Allah's word a lie. But making this a rational discussion, I think it is fair to point out the following. We know that even in Muhammad's day, men changed and twisted the Quran. Surah 15:89. And say, surely I am the plain warner, like as we sent down on the dividers those who made the Quran into shreds. So even during his life, men shredded the Quran. So Muhammad created or received this revelation condemning them. So if you really want to apply Jeremiah 8:8 as some proof that some texts were changed, you must also realize Surah 15:91 confirms the Quran was shredded, changed. But there is also another aspect of Islam's claim you must consider. Jeremiah came as a prophet at a certain time in history, and God revealed his message over a span of 3,000 years. Even if Jeremiah spoke of some corruption, it could only refer to scriptures delivered before his time. I think, brother, that is an aspect of the Torah and Bible which Muslims are never aware of. The history of the prophets is over thousands of years, not one man's lifetime. And every prophet came confirming the scriptures that remained, calling the Jews back to God and his law. I would say Islam twists how the statement of Jeremiah 8:8 is interpreted, and that dishonesty proves to me Islam is a false path that does not respect God's word. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.